Make your own talking bearded clam. Go on, you know you want to.
Hello, my name's Alison and welcome to my puppet workshop. Today I'm going to show you how to make a bearded clam.
Hello, I'm a clam.
So this is a little paper puppet that I've made. If I turn him over, you can see that he's got a little handle on the back and a little paper mechanism so that when I push the stick up and down,
my mouth flaps open. Yay! I'm a clam!
So if you're ready to make your own bearded clam puppet, take a look inside your pack. There you'll find two pieces of paper. One of them is an instruction sheet with some templates on for you to cut out. That's mounted on a piece of white card. The other sheet of paper is a list of all the things you'll need to make your puppet, which you can find inside the envelope. And don't forget, you'll need a pair of scissors. Okay, I think we're ready to start.
Something fishy's going on around here.
We're going to cut out this big shell, this long stem attached to the smaller shell. This is all one piece. We've got a little bit of backing for the eyes, so you can pop your googly eyes on there if you want to, or draw some eyes on. And this handle here, which sits on the back. Don't worry about the little one. That's just showing you how to fold this. So, get ready to do some cutting out. This could take a little bit of time, so talk amongst yourselves.
All that cutting out, it's good for your muscles. Get it? Your muscles. I'm a clam!
I've cut these templates off the instruction sheet a bit roughly, and now I'm going to neaten them up. It doesn't have to be perfect. Just make sure your shell has got a nice wiggly edge. There's my shell. This bit is the stem of my puppet. I need to cut around these little tabs that I've labelled A and B. They're quite important. And I'll show you why in a minute, once I've finished all of this chopping out. This shell here is going to be the flapping mouth part of your puppet. There we go. That's the second shell and the stem chopped out. Then's my little handle. It's just a little rectangle with a couple of folds in it. So now I've got all four of my pieces that I need. I'm ready to start putting them together. What you need to do now, if you look through your instruction sheet, you fold in tab A and tab B along the dotted line, and you tuck them in like that. And then we're going to post everything down through the slit that we've cut in the big shell, like this. And those little tabs, they're going to get pushed through too. All right. Tuck everything in. And once it's tucked through, we can open them back out again. Can you see that? And now they won't push back up through the hole. And we've almost got our talking clam. One last thing we need to do is to fold the red dotted line, which I've labelled C. So you fold that towards you. Okay, and now when I push the stem, my puppet starts to talk.
Flap, 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 flapping marvellous.
I'm going to stiffen up this stem a little bit because it's a little bit wobbly, and that's why I found this lolly stick and I put a bit of double-sided sticky tape on here and here. If I can get the back off. It's always good to have some fingernails for this job. Peel off the backing. There we go. And I'm going to stick this lolly stick onto the back of my stem like that. And that just makes everything a little bit stiffer. Oh, that's better.
Oh, yes.
Before I decorate, I might as well finish putting on my handle on the back. There's a little demonstration on the instruction sheet to show you how to fold this, but you fold two sides in like that, and then you fold these end little bits out again like that. So what you get is a little handle shape like that. And this, if I add a couple of sticky pads, I can easily stick this to the back of my puppet. Okay, peel off the back. Turn this over. And I've got myself a really nice, sturdy little handle to hold. Ta-da! So, yeah, I think you need some eyes, don't you? I'm going to use my sticky-backed googly eyes. If I can peel the back off these. Pop one onto my little eyepiece. You see how it makes them stand out, having a bit of a background? You could always cut out a different colour if you like. Those on there, and I want to stick those somewhere on there, so I'll turn it over and get, oh, there's a little piece of sticky pad left over. I'll pop that on there, peel off the back, and now I can stick my eyes right where I want them.
Hello. That's better.
So, only one thing missing, a bit of beard.
Yeah.
So, I've got this fur that I found, and I've put the sticky foam on the back. I've just got to decide where I want to stick it, really. I think I might put some behind there for eyebrows. And what about a nice goatee beard? I think I'll put it up there. It could be a moustache. What do you think? Quite like that. I think I might make him have a moustache like that. So I'll just peel off the back again. Put on there. Peel off this piece. Stick it on there. It's like one of those moustaches that's got a parting in the middle. Very nice. And the back of this, and I might just stick it on behind the eyes like that. There we go. Very nice. Ah.
Oh, it's a bit tickly. Achoo!
I found one of these little sticky half pearls. You can get them from craft shops. It's not essential at all, but I can stick that in there, and now my clam has got a very special
pearl inside there. I'm complete. Yay!
What should I do with him now?
It's my birthday today. Did you get me a present?
No.
You're so shellfish!
Oh yeah. Shellfish.
Well, I hope you enjoyed making your puppets today. Have fun playing with them. Bye for now.